This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show a couple of ways to find the area of an irregular polygon. So I've got these two polygons, and I'm going to want to find the area for each one. Let's start with the green one. Sometimes when you've got a very irregular shape, a nice thing to do is to break that shape down into smaller parts that will be easier to measure. So for instance, I can draw a line here, and I've created a triangle, and using these dots as 1-inch measures, I could now figure out that if this were to be the base of the triangle would have a base of 2, and its height going this way would be 1. So I know the area of a triangle is 1/2 the base times the height. The base times the height is 2 times 1, or 2, and 1/2 of 2 is 1. So this triangle will have an area of 1 square inch. Now I can take the remaining part, divide that into two triangles, and find the area for each one of those. This triangle has a base of 2, and a height that is also 2. So the base times the height is 2 times 2, or 4. And 1/2 the base times the height would be 1/2 of 4, or 2. So this triangle has an area of 2 square inches. I've got one triangle remaining. I'll call this long side the base, and that means the base has a length of 1, 2, 3, 4 inches. The height would be right here. That would be 1 inch. So 4 times 1 is 4, and 1/2 of that would be 2. So this triangle also has an area of 2 square inches. Now I just have to add the areas of those three triangles together. 2 plus 2 is 4, plus 1 is 5. And that tells me the area for the entire irregular polygon is going to be 5 square inches. Let's go on to the red polygon. Sometimes it's going to be hard to divide your irregular polygon into shapes that are easy to measure. When that happens, you might try something like this. Draw a box to enclose the polygon. Then find out the area of the entire box. And if you can, find out the area of the parts of the box that are not the polygon. Then subtract those areas from the area of the entire box, and that will tell you how much is left for the polygon itself. So, for instance, this box has a length of 4, or width of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and it's 1, 2, 3, 4 units high, 4 inches high. So the area of this entire box is 16 square inches. Now I'm going to find the area of each of these three triangles. So this triangle over here, we could call this left side the base. That would have a base of 2 and a height of 1. So the area would be the base times the height, 2 times 1, divided by 2, which would be 1. So this area is 1 square inch. Over here, the triangle on the right side has a base, if we want to think of the right side as the base, has a base of 1, 2, 3 inches and a height of 2 inches. So base times height is 2 times 3, or 6. 1/2 of 6 is 3. So this triangle has an area of 3 square inches. And the triangle down here at the bottom has a base of 4 and a height of 2. 2 times 4 is 8. 1/2 of 8 is 4. So this has an area of 4 square inches. If I add those together, 4 plus 1 is 5, plus 3 is 8. I'll take that 8 and subtract it from the area of the entire box, and that will tell me how much this red polygon is. So 16, the area of the entire box, minus 8, the area of these three white areas, is 8. That means that this red polygon has an area of 8 square inches. And that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.